Hello, recently OpenAI announced that ChatGPT will be coming to their API soon. While we don't know how long that it will take, we can test OpenAI API today for free. By learning the OpenAI today, you will be able to access OpenAI powerful models such as GPT-3 for natural language tasks, Codex to translate natural language to code, and DALLE-E to create and edit original images. In this video, we will learn how to use OpenAI API with Python. Before we start working with the OpenAI, we need to log in into our OpenAI account and generate our API keys. Remember that OpenAI will not display your secret API key again after you generate it, so copy your API key and save it. Before jumping to the fun part, let's firstly install OpenAI package to our Python environment. Type pip install OpenAI and press enter. This package is not heavy, so it will be installed in seconds. And that's it. Successfully installed OpenAI 0.26.2. Text completion can be used for classification, text generation, conversation, transformation, conversion, summarization, and our task. To work with it, we have to use the completion endpoint and give the model a prompt. Then the model will generate text that attempts to match the context or a given pattern. Let's say we want to classify this sentence. I did not like the new Batman move. This is a tweet and we ask the model to decide if this positive, neutral or negative. We need to set up the response configuration which defines the model we are using. Prompt itself. Maximum number of tokens used. And temperature. Good to know that according to the OpenAI docs, GPT-3 models are meant to be used with the text completion endpoint. That's why we are using model text DaVinci 003 for this example. Let's run this Python file and here you go. The model understood what task we asked to do with the given sentence and it is classified to be as negative. And that is correct. Perfect. Metadata about the results also available just here in the response output. Here are some other examples using this text completion script. The first one. What is the average living cost in Zurich for a regular family per month? Answer looks good. The second one. Why Facebook changed name to Meta? Answer looks good also. And the last one, what are lyrics of DJ Tiesto 1035 song? Here model is wrong, because it is not trained on such questions as look like this. Another task for the OpenAI, code completion. Let's create another Python script for this. Let's name it codecompletion.py. Fine. And let's quickly make changes from the previous code version. First of all, we change a prompt message. It is a string line. As I checked, we need to use specifically this string convention at the beginning and at the end of this string line. Let's finish that. Okay, looks good. Here in the middle, let's write something meaningful. Create an array of weather temperature for Paris. Model indicator should be text DaVinci 002. Let's change max token to be equal to 256. Then top 1 equal to 1. Frequency penalty equal to 0. And presence penalty equal to 0 also. These are 3 additional parameters for code completion model and we'll print the result right here. So let's run this script. We can see the generated data right here, which you can directly paste into your notebook or whatever you want to visualize. Here I have load values representing temperatures. So let's check how it looks like as a plot. This is a Jupyter notebook based on Python where I can do anything I want with this data. Here I converted it to pandas data frame and visualized as a plot just below. Also, you can try to use a playground space available at beta.openai.com. So, give me an array of Paris temperature. Submitting. And here it is, an array with values answering to my question. Last use case in this video, image generation with DALL-E. We need extra one file for this task. Let's name it imageGeneration.py. So, we need the same API key. That is fine. For image generation, we also should set up a configuration for the response we expect to get from the OpenAI API. First one is the most important, prompt. What we exactly want the model will draw for us. Let's play. A flatty dark cat with gray eyes sitting in a basket of flowers, looking straight to the camera. Our parameters. N equal to 1 and size equal to 124 by 124 pixels. So, from that response we need to extract an image URL address generated by the API. By opening this generated link, we will be able to check the image and save it to our computer. We will print this image URL just below right here. So again, here's a prompt which tells the model what we need to get in the picture, and here's the image size. Let's run this small script right now. Small syntax error, I missed a comma after the prompt. Fixing, that's done. Run it again. And finally, the link is generated. Let's open it up. Copy and paste it to your browser, and here you go. A dark cat sitting in a basket of flowers, looking straight to the camera. Exactly what we asked to draw. Here are some hours AI-generated images with the same script. You can play with that for free. So, we prepared 3 different Python scripts for 3 different tasks: text completion, code completion, and image generation. All these scripts are available at my GitHub. The link is in the description of this video. Have fun and see you in the next video.